supposed to put fair market value on your property, what it's gonna sell for, so.
Or these value comfortable with the sale price, or are they comfortable with your evaluation based on the?
It is kind of a meet in the middle. That's because within every group, you're gonna have stupid sales, and you're gonna have people that got a bargain. And I have to try to weed through, you know, I'm not gonna give all my weight to the guy that paid double what it's worth just because, for whatever reason, they loved it, you know, who knows? Who knows what the motivations of buyers are? But it's pretty easy to tell, you know, if somebody pays 40% more than what we have on it, and I've reviewed the property, I know that all our characteristics are correct, then that's just, it's just one of those things. So yeah, you try to kind of meet in the middle. If you have, I guess the better way of putting it is, if you have 10 sales that all sold for 8 to 14% over what you have, well then, there's your trend. You know, you're looking at an 8 to 10 to 12% increase, because you want to be in the middle of what you got. So, I mean, does that answer your question?
Yeah.
Okay, I hope.
Well, no. I'm gonna pick on you. Okay.
Uh-huh.
You, for instance, your value went up, say, 43.5.
I have a big house.
Okay.
I have the biggest house.
Regardless of the size of the house, but what I'm trying to get to is, if you put it on the market sale, will you sell for what you have it listed or more?
I would probably ask more. Do I think, honest to goodness, do I think I could get what I have? I would expect to at least get that. If I could get more, I'd be happy. You know, a farm just down the street from me just went on the market this week, and I was pretty eager to see what they listed it for. They listed it for about $400,000 over what I know. Wait a minute, let me go back. About $500,000 over what I have on it.
Is that the white fence area?
So
if they get that, they hit the lottery.
The question is, you're going to need to hit it.
Yeah.
Exactly. I mean, is that going to that one sale for that much money? Is that going to drive your assessment up?
No. Unless it just happens that we have four other people that buy large tracts of land and pay $6,000 or $7,000 an acre for it, well then I'm going to have to pay attention. But if there's only one, no, I won't. And let's talk about what else I was asked to talk about, which is what you want to know. I was asked to discuss, if one house sells in a neighborhood, do I change the whole neighborhood? And the answer is, it depends. It depends on the house, it depends on the sale, it depends on the size of the group that it's included in. I mean, I have to take all those things into consideration, and, you know, but my priority is to be fair to all the property owners in the county. If your type of property is selling for more than what I have it valued at, I have to raise it. If not, I don't. I spend months doing this analysis. I go out, I look at the sales, I make sure that what I have is correct. Because if I'm going to raise everybody else based on a sale, I've got to make sure that I'm right. And then here's another point I wanted to point out to you. I put, you know, even if there's no sales in a neighborhood, I may still change it. And an example of that is Ashwood Meadows. I changed Ashwood Meadows this year based on the activity in Jones Estates. Because, again, that's fair, because it's basically the same neighborhood. They were built right around the same time. They're the same size houses. It's fair to the people in Jones Estates that I do that to the people in Ashwood Meadows. And on top of that, this year we've already had a sale in Ashwood Meadows, which validates us bumping it up as well. So, you know, I have all my neighborhoods grouped together by type. And so if you've had a lot of sales in a type of neighborhood, then I'm going to apply that to similar neighborhoods, because common sense is going to tell you, you know, if somebody's paying $120,000 for a house in Jones Estates, they're probably going to pay $120,000 for one in Ashwood Meadows as well, because it's basically the same thing. And that generally holds true.
Now, I'm gonna go back to me, I'm looking at me, and, you know, people will ask that question, when you see none increase in value, why was no increase?
Because in the city, what happened this year, there were some sales over the current values, but there were just as many under the current values, or close to the current values.
But would it be the same square footage and the size of the?
Well, the city's a little more different because that's what you call a non-homogeneous neighborhood. Jones Estates is easy. All the houses are the same. They're the same square footage. They're basically the same style. You know, here's the thing, like I tell people, you know, well, nothing's sold on my road. Well, yeah, but with the rural part of the county, you can't wait until something sells on your road. I mean, if something sells on Liberty Church, whatever's going on Liberty Church is probably going to happen on, you know, Post Road or Bethel Church Road. It's generally the same types of property. So that's my opinion. And it's, you know, here's the thing. And here's another point. I mean, I've been doing this for 12 years. I think this is my 12th digest. I do the same thing every year. I break it down the same way. And it's been working in my opinion.
Here's what.
If I were to score, say, just a 36, it would cost the county well over $100,000, if not close to $200,000. That's just if I don't do my job properly, you're out that money.
So further away from you from that 40%.
It's the more money.
The more money.
And yes, in years past, this county had ratios of 32.
Right.
So they were losing
for years.
And lots of money. As it is right now, you pay tax on what you have, and it's worth a lot. You're going to pay a lot of tax. I mean, I don't mean to sound cold, but if you can't afford it. And you know what? Let me just throw this out at y'all. Today, there was a man in there this morning, and he built this big, huge brick house, and he comes in every year all upset about how much he has to pay. And I said, well, you know, look at it this way. Okay, let's say you had to drive to Atlanta every day for work, but you had this car, and it only got 10 miles to the gallon. Would you just keep driving it and keep driving it if you couldn't afford it? No, you would sell it and get something else. And if you have this big, huge house and you can't afford it, if you can't afford the property taxes, how do you afford the insurance? How do you afford the utilities? So, you know, it all kind of goes hand in hand. Just not being able to afford your property taxes is only going to be one part of it. So, I don't know, but that's just me.
Well,